Well, unfortunately, and I have nothing about the Germans these days, but they were really devil people. Hitler was a complete moron who really made life. Why he hated Jews, I have no idea. Because suddenly, all the countries that the German occupied, there were laws. You're Jewish? First of all, you have to register. You have to wear a Star of David in the front and the back of your clothes. You cannot be seen in the street after 8 p.m. And the rules and rules, and then deportations. And in our home, I know in 1942, the French policemen came to arrest a lot of Jews who were not French citizens at that time. If you were French citizen, they will leave you alone. But it was unbelievable. Suddenly all my friends and their family, they're going into a police cars, and who knows where they're going? We did not know. And then on the September, at the end of September, it was our turn. We were taken first in a camp outside of Paris called Drancy, where we didn't stay there. But 2 days later, we were deported. I'm not talking about a lot of people, because maybe older people knew what they were doing, where they're going. I did not know that once we're in a car, we're going to go to Germany and kill in the gas chambers. And that's exactly what they did. They needed, the reason we are alive, the ones who survived, is because the German soldiers were occupying Europe, so they needed people to work. And if you were able to work in their factories, then they will not kill you for the moment. But the others, I mean, it's like I'm seeing it today when we arrive in a place called Kozel, which is the border of Poland and Czechoslovakia, and they open the wagons and say, "Don," and I was 16 years old, I looked like 12, and I went down with one of my brother-in-law, because my parents didn't, my father was already 72, he was too old, and one soldier looked at me on the ground and said, "Go back on the train." And my it's fate and it's luck. I stayed in the front of the open the train and passing water for the people, because we didn't drink for 3 days. It was awful. And then another soldier came and said, "How old are you?" And somebody answered for me, 16, "Done." And if he didn't say that, I would have gone to the gas chamber with my parents. And that person said, "Done," saved my life.